Hi, welcome to a brief stargazing guide for October. This month, we'll still be able to see some remaining summer objects in the west. The eastern and large part of the southern sky, though, are filled with autumn objects. In this year's October, the three superior planets, Mars, Jupiter, and Saturn, are also in clear view for midnight viewers. These guides are intended to be usable for viewers in areas with moderate light pollution, like in the backyards of urban homes. So we begin our tour of the night sky with identification of objects bright enough to be seen from light polluted areas, and then we proceed to identify related objects that may require darker skies to see. That way, these guides are useful also in dark skies for the less visible details. We use illustrations presenting the sky as it would appear to a person viewing from about 50 degrees north of equator in October, around 11 p.m. to midnight. These illustrations have been obtained from Stellarium app, but can also be accessed using Stellarium web at this address. The main constellation for this guide is Auriga, the charioteer, which is in the eastern sky here. In the course of visiting Auriga, we will identify the stars Capella and Aldebaran. We'll also see the open cluster Pleiades, also known as the Seven Sisters, and other constellations, namely Perseus and Cassiopeia. More importantly, for October 2022, the red planet Mars will be in clear view in the eastern sky at midnight. In the southern sky, we are going to see the constellations Andromeda, the princess, and Pegasus, the winged horse. We'll also see the first zodiac constellation Aries, the Ram, and the Great Square of Pegasus, Asterisms. For October 2022, we still have Jupiter in clear view, straight south at midnight, and Saturn, which has now moved to the southwestern sky. In the western sky, we'll see some summer objects, namely the Summer Triangle and the Northern Cross Asterisms, together with the constellation Cygnus, the Swan. Let us begin by finding Auriga in the eastern sky. Looking east and raising your eyes up to somewhere between the horizon and overhead, find a dominant, bright, and relatively whitish star in that area. That is the star Capella, the little god. It is the sixth brightest star in the night sky. You will know that you're looking at Capella if to the lower left side of it you can find another distinctly visible star, though not as bright here. This star is Mencalinan, another star in the constellation Auriga. There are three more clearly visible stars that we can connect with lines like this. To complete the shape of Auriga, we need to trace back to Capella through some dimmer stars in the middle, like this. In some drawings of Auriga, an extension is made to include a much dimmer star on the left upward side, like this, and a little extension to the other side, like this. That completes the shape of Auriga. To the right of Auriga, there is another reddish bright star which we can connect with a line like this. This star is a red giant, Aldebaran, the brightest star in the constellation Taurus. Aldebaran is also referred to as the Eye of the Bull. For October 2022, you will see the red planet Mars between Auriga and Aldebaran, and by mid-month, it will appear about where it is in this illustration. Since Mars is a planet that is very close to us, it will appear to advance eastwards day by day relative to the stars behind it, but this will happen at increasingly slower pace as it is nearing the point of retrograde motion, where it will appear to make a turnaround and start to move in westward direction relative to the background stars. Before we leave the eastern sky, let us identify other objects. From Auriga, if you sweep your eyes up, you will see five stars forming distinct W shape overhead, looking like this. This is the constellation Cassiopeia, the queen. Now, drawing a line to connect Capella with Cassiopeia like this, you will find another distinctly visible star on the right-hand side here, which you can connect with lines from Capella and Cassiopeia like this to form a triangle shape. This star is Mirfak, the brightest star in the constellation Perseus, the hero. Perseus looks like this. To see more about the constellation Perseus, please watch my previous video. The last object I would like us to visit in this side of the sky is the open cluster Pleiades, the Seven Sisters. This is a group of stars that may look like a bright patch of light depending on the sky condition. It is located about 440 light years away. To find this, we will use the stars Capella and Mirfak and look for a patch of light formed by stars to the right here that we can connect with lines from Capella and Mirfak to form a triangle shape like this. If you have done it right, then you have found Pleiades, the Seven Sisters. You can also confirm that you're looking at Pleiades by drawing a line to Aldebaran and see if you get a shape like this. Both Pleiades and Aldebaran are in the constellation Taurus. Next is the southern sky. Facing straight south, most of the bright stars are close to overhead. My best way of identifying objects in this area in October is to begin with the brightest star in the constellation Perseus, which we saw in the east. And now, because we are looking south, Perseus is to the left overhead here. And Cassiopeia is to the right of Perseus here. Now, from the brightest star in Perseus, Mirfak, you can see at least four bright stars running in the forward rightward direction, even if you are in a light polluted sky, that you can connect with lines like this. The first three are part of the constellation Andromeda, the princess, which looks like this. And the remaining are part of the constellation Pegasus, the winged horse, that looks like this. In this position, the horse is upside down with its front legs here and the neck and head here. Our neighboring galaxy Andromeda is here. The great square of Pegasus Asterisms is the winged horse with its legs and head removed, looking like this. For more about Andromeda and Pegasus, please watch my previous videos. Talking about constellations, let me add one more that has at least one star bright enough for an urban viewer to see. Remember the line that we drew from Mirfak connecting five bright stars? We can draw another one from Mirfak connecting three bright stars on the lower side, or rather in front of the first line, because we are literally looking overhead. The second line should look like this. If you got it right, the bright star at the end here is in the constellation Aries, the Ram. Aries is a relatively small constellation and the first sign of zodiac in the neighborhood of Andromeda constellation. The rest of stars in Aries may be hard to see if you're watching from light polluted sky. So I will just complete its shape, and if you are in a dark sky area, you can do it with me. One line to the left connecting with one star, and another to the right connecting with two stars. Lastly, in the southern sky, the brightest object in October 2022 is the planet Jupiter, and the second brightest object with a little orange tan in the southwestern sky is the planet Saturn. Jupiter is the first thing you will see at midnight in the southern sky in October 2022. You might wonder why I did not talk about the planets first. And the reason is that the stars are fixed relative to each other and their position in each season of the year. Planets, on the other hand, are moving relative to the stars and constellations. So where you see them in this illustration is specific to October 2022. If we watch the sky in October next year and the rest of October's in your lifetime, the stars and constellations will appear to be where they are, while the planets will appear to have moved eastwards against the stars and constellations. One way to tell which planet is farther away is to look at how fast it moves relative to the background stars. So I invite you to mark where Jupiter and Saturn is and compare with where they will be in October next year. Lastly, the western sky. Looking west and raising your eyes towards overhead, you will see the summer triangle Asterism as a dominant object, marked by the three bright stars Vega, Altair, and Deneb. It is always interesting to imagine how big and bright is the star Deneb. While Vega is estimated to be 25 light years away and Altair only 17 light years away, Deneb is way over 2000 light years away according to some estimates. Deneb is the brightest star in the constellation Cygnus, the Swan. Cygnus looks like this. the graceful swan flying in the westward direction at the reference time and place of this guide. If we cut the tips of the wings of Cygnus, the swan, we remain with the Northern Cross asterism. You might have noticed that Cassiopeia, the queen, is behind the swan here. And the region to the right, we can see the asterism's Big Dipper out here and the Little Dipper and the constellation Draco in between. That brings us to the end of our brief tour of the night sky in October in the Northern Hemisphere. It is my hope that you have found it helpful. If so, please like, and I will also appreciate your comments. Thank you.